Listen to it. Mirror, mirror, the reflection of the law. Welcome back to my trading journal. Now I know it has been a really, really long time, maybe like a year since I did my last YouTube video, but for those of you who follow me across all socials, you have definitely seen me on TikTok, on Instagram, yada, yada, yada. This is kind of an update video to let you guys know where I am right now and what my plans are and just, yeah, checking in with a girl. I know it's been a hot minute since I did a YouTube video, but now that I have got my new setup, literally this arrived a couple of days ago and I've only just gotten a chance to set this up, and I'm not going to do a whole like computer, like this is my trading computer now, and I'm not going to do a full walkthrough of the spec today, but if you guys would like me to do a full walkthrough of the spec, then I absolutely can, just to walk you through the equipment that I bought for my trading journey, this next stage of my trading journey. So for those of you who don't know me, hi, my name is Jessica. I've been trading since 2019, so I'm now officially in my fifth year, which is absolutely bonkers, and it has been quite the journey. And I have been doing this alongside, you know, my performance career in the film and TV industry. I'm first and foremost a dancer, that will never end. So literally 2023 was possibly the craziest year of my performance career ever. I was working back to back on multiple productions, all still whilst being committed to my trading, doing it every single day with my team and just really maintaining everything that we talk about, the consistency, the patience, and everything that goes in between. So unfortunately, I can't actually disclose the things I have been working on, but some of you may have seen the most recent Marvel's film that just came out recently, and I am in that, which you may not have known. So it's working in things like that that I do alongside my trading, and they work hand in hand. So when I'm not on a film set, when I'm not on production, I will be at home trading and, you know, using this to fund all of the other areas in my life. So funding my mortgage, paying for all of my training, especially when you're training for the stunt register, like doing gymnastics, trampolining, high diving, rock climbing, horse riding, taekwondo, everything that comes, these all have a high price point. So I use my trading actively to fund my creative career. So for those of you who aren't new, and this whole spiel is totally like, you know this inside and out, I've been saying the same thing for the last 5 years. Trade smart to fund your art. And I've recently just finished on a super exciting production. I was on that job for the last, what? Like, feels like forever. The last 10 weeks, it's been very, very intense. And now that we're done, we can now get back into trading all day, every day. Which is actually a lie, because I don't trade all day, every day. But upping my trading. As you guys know, I really enjoy doing long-term swing trading. That has always really been my bag. Yes, I love a good scalping session, but swing trading has always been the thing that's been the most successful for me, just because I'm a busy girl. I don't know about any of you guys, but I don't like sitting at my computer 24/7 and trading for hours and hours on end. That was never gonna be me. And to be realistic, that's not really the majority of us out there either. A lot of us have working jobs. You know, we have, a lot of you guys have 9-to-5s. I don't have 9-to-5, I instead have like 4 a.m. till 8 p.m. That's my standard technical working day if I'm on set. And I'm training, doing X, Y, and Z all the time. I'm here, there, and everywhere. So to have long-term swing positions that are constantly ticking along in the background whilst I'm doing all these other things in my life has always been, you know, what's worked best for me. When I do scalping sessions, really, really fun. I'll usually do them for like an hour, half an hour, depending on what strategies I'm looking at. But this computer setup really is for that. And also for me to provide more streaming opportunities. So yes, your girl does like a bit of a game, okay? But this is also for me to share my charts with you whilst I'm also doing my streaming. So when I've been doing my trading before, I have always been using my MacBook. Great for being able to move about very freely. However, I wasn't really able, it just didn't have the capacity to be using Steam and be sharing my screen. It just didn't really have that power as a device. So now that I've got this set up, I can now be giving you guys more and more and more. And yes, I've got one screen, okay? I have one screen. I've also got my iPad here as well, which I do work from. So I've got the iPad always ready to go as well. I do like using my iPad to like drawing on the charts. So when I'm doing my Zoom calls, drawing on the charts has been really helpful, actually. It's been a while since I did a video, huh? I've like totally forgotten how to do it. So I still have my iPad here and I've only got this one screen here. Really beautiful. I really wanted to make sure I had an all white setup because my aesthetic, of course, as you know, is all white and it's stunning. But literally this computer has only just been set up this morning. So I haven't even like changed the background on this thing. So I'm gonna do that now. So I did download Steam Wallpaper Engine. I did do a little TikTok research because I wanted like a cute, cozy background that would fit my vibe. And all the recommendations were to download Steam and then get the Wallpaper Engine, which I have done. So now I'm gonna find a wallpaper that works really great for me. Now done, I've now chosen my wallpaper background. I kind of went for like a medieval village, but I really wanted it to be a motion background. I wanted it to be a moving background. So it's got like the steam, it's got the water, it's got the sun rays, and it's absolutely beautiful. So I'll probably, you can do loads of kind of adjustments on them using steam, so I will look into that a little bit later, but at least I've got something that I'm really happy with. I'm still trying to like suss out the vibe of my setup, even though my lighting, I always have like pink and purple lighting, but I do really like the warm colors. I do like oranges, I do like browns, I do like green. So I don't know, we'll just kind of see what the vibe is as I kind of get more stuff added to my surrounding collection. Pay no attention to the wires, please. I know it's such a mess. And again, in an ideal situation, I would have wanted all white. So it's just gonna take some time for me to replace kind of like everything till it's an all white system. Obviously we've got the PC itself is white, and then I've got a white monitor. The stand isn't white, this is silver. So I will probably do a little DIY spray job on that and make that sure that's white, and then order some white cables as well. So everything looks super duper seamless. You know how we are with the vibe. Also, whilst I'm here, I'm gonna set up Google Chrome because I haven't done that yet at all. So once I get Google Chrome set up, then that means I can also get my charts up and actually start doing some trading, which is gonna be awesome. Literally, you guys don't know how long I've been waiting for this computer. It just never really seemed like the right time. I always had other priorities, but just towards the end of this year, I really decided that I wanted to honor my inner child a little bit more and just listen to the things that she wanted to do. I've always been super sensible and always focused on the priorities first, and I've never really allowed myself to do the level of gaming or anything that I really wanted to do, and this is definitely the year for that. We now have the charts all set up. This computer is actually quite loud, like it's just whirring and going crazy. This YouTube channel has always been, you know, like a documentation of my journey. It's never really been much of like an education space. I kind of tried it a couple of years ago, but I kind of got a bit bored of doing the education side of things and not necessarily just telling you guys about my journey and what I'm up to. So I feel like I'm not really sure what kind of direction my YouTube channel is heading to, but if you have any ideas of videos that you would like me to do, please do let me know. If you would like me to be going over some of the basics like pips, how to calculate stop losses, how to set buy limits and sell limits, all of those things that are really important for beginners that we don't necessarily get, I don't know, you don't really get that kind of handholding in a lot of spaces. So if you would like those videos, do let me know, because I can create them for you now that we've got the setup of my dreams. Also some fun gaming content as well, so if you guys have any games that you would like me to play, then please do let me know. I'm actually going to Thailand tomorrow, which is hilarious. It's just been an absolute whirlwind of a couple of weeks. I've just finished filming and then had a break for a couple of days. I've had some dilemmas in my personal life, and now I'm heading out to Thailand tomorrow. So just gonna be really super excited to be out there again and to be able to document my trading journey whilst I'm out there. I was gonna do more vlogging when I was out there the last time, but I just really wanted that time to chill and just really rest, man, because all the time we're just constantly creating content and I just really wanted to chillax. This time I'm gonna be doing more documentation of my travels whilst I'm out there and showing you guys what I get up to alongside my trading every single day. Honestly, it's just gonna be me hanging out in coffee shops and traveling around Bangkok and just, I don't know, having a whale of a time, but showing you how you can live a relatively nomadic lifestyle, being a creative, being a freelancer, and using trading to actually do the thing and, you know, fund your lifestyle whichever way you want to do it. So what I'm gonna do right now super quick is go through all of my charts and see where we're at. Today is Friday, so it's not the best trading day, but I am gonna just be checking out my long-term positions, seeing where we're at and seeing what needs any adjustments. Realizing that I need already, it's almost like, because I've been so hands-on using my iPad so much of the time, I'm finding it like I'm wanting to touch my screen, so I feel like I need a little trackpad or something down here that can allow me to manipulate the screen as well as using the mouse. It just feels a bit long going from like side to side. So I don't know if anyone knows of any like secondary keyboards that I could use to help with TradingView. If you guys have it, if you guys know of anyone who has any cool tech, please let me know, because I'm a tech girly and I'd love to add some more stuff to my setup. So classic me running out of battery. I'm gonna have to get a new battery before I head out. But I hope you guys enjoyed this little catch-up video. Short, sweet, to the point, but it just let you know that I am here. We are still in action, even though I haven't been on YouTube for an incredibly long time. But the trading journey has never ever stopped. Priorities will always shift around, but trading should always be your constant. Like yoga, like ballet class, it is something that you should be doing every single day. And remember, a trade a day can keep the tax man away. Trade a day keeps the recession at bay. Lol, hilarious. The UK is now officially in a recession, although, you know, we've been in a financial crisis for a really, really long time. Another video for another day. We can definitely talk about that. If you guys would like some any more videos regarding specific topics, I'm more than happy to let you guys take the wheel in what I should be posting in my upcoming content. But it feels so good to be back. Feels so good to be an actual setup and not being a digital nomad like I always feel like I am, between different properties, between here, there, and everywhere. Again, if you want another video about my property journey, we can do that as well. Yeah, but it's just nice to be back, and yeah, stay safe out there, trader babies, and I'll see you on the charts. Bye.